department heads.
Well, Tiffany, you won't find anybody who's very happy with what they're getting in this proposed budget, from the taxpayers to the fire chief to librarians. But with no light at the end of the fiscal tunnel, the mayor says this is the best way forward.
In his budget address Tuesday night, Manchester Mayor Ted Gatsas called for shared sacrifice.
Sacrifice that, while very painful for most, is required to avoid bankrupting this city and driving taxpayers out.
His plan includes a 3.37% property tax increase and layoffs for 200 school paraprofessionals and 50 city employees. The mayor acknowledges that the biggest personnel cuts are likely to come at the biggest departments, highway, fire, and police.
This cut is deep. But as Chief Myra said to all of us in this room, and I quote, the city will be safe.
When a citizen calls the police, we're going to be there. We're not going to come any slower. They need the police, we're going to be there. We're going to be, our officers, patrol officers are going to be out there.
But Police Chief David Mara says the current funding tabbed for his department will have consequences.
We have six divisions. Things such as detectives, they're going to have bigger caseloads, traffic, juvenile.
The fire chief says the mayor's budget would force 22 layoffs in his department.
The impact would look like three ladder trucks would be placed out of service. All stations would remain open.
Another proposed cut would close the West Side Library branch, an idea that is likely to result in quite a bit of citizen pressure on aldermen in wards 10, 11, and 12. But longtime board members say there's not a lot of room for budget addbacks this year.
I think there's less flexibility in this budget than I've seen in my 12 years.
Mayor Gatsas also offered something of an open hand to city unions today, saying that further finger-pointing would be counterproductive. He's still looking for concessions, but only, he says, if they result in meaningful, long-term cost savings. Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.